Welcome, fellow scientists, to the last lesson of Structures of Science. Throughout this course, you have accomplished some incredible things, so I thought, what better way to bring it to a close than with a challenge? By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to design and conduct an experiment of your own making. Let's get into it. We've learned a lot about how the universe is built during our time together, from the tiniest of atoms to the greatest feats of engineering. All the knowledge we've collected is thanks to generations of people using the scientific method to learn. And you've been using the scientific method all along to help solve my problems, whether it was teaching me how to be a better plant parent or making me appreciate the source of my heartburn, you were there. Now, it's time to solve a problem of your own. You'll be designing an experiment from start to finish, but first, you have to find a question to test. Have you made any observations lately that sparked your interest? If not, try taking a look around. You may be surprised by just how much inspiration lies in our daily lives. Does bread always land butter side down? Is a double-stuffed Oreo really double-stuffed? Which detergent will finally get those grass stains out of my jeans? Whatever question you come up with, make sure it's scientific. Remember, a scientific question is objective, specific, and testable. Take a moment to rewatch our lesson on scientific questions if you need a refresher. Once you have your question, it's time to design your experiment. First, list the materials you'll need, then write out the steps of your procedure. Be detailed. Anyone should be able to follow your steps and repeat your experiment. Think about what needs to stay constant in your experiment and what needs to change. Once all your steps are written out, record your hypothesis. Be sure to include the effect of your independent variable on your dependent one. What are you changing? What effect do you think that change will cause? When that's all set, it's time to gather your materials and begin your experiment. Remember to take detailed notes and record all your observations. They're the data you'll use to see if your hypothesis is supported. After you've completed your experiment, it's time to analyze the data. Was your hypothesis supported? Whether or not it was, you've learned something valuable. Finally, report your results. You can create a poster, write a report, or even make a video presentation. Consider posting your results to our MIA community. Sharing your findings helps others learn from your work and is a big part of being a scientist. And there you have it. You're ready to take on the challenge of using the scientific method to solve your own problems. I can't wait to see what amazing discoveries you make. It has been so much fun learning with you, fellow scientists, and remember, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey, hey.